Today we are going to find out the internal resistance of the cell using potentiometer. Now in this circuit diagram, this is point A, this is the potentiometer wire. From point A, we will connect three wires, one to the positive of the driver cell, one to the resistance box, and one to the cell whose internal resistance we are finding out. From the resistance, you will go to the key, and where the negative of the cell is there, that will go to the galvanometer, and galvanometer to the chalky. Now let us go to our circuit. Now this one, this long one, is the potentiometer wire. Now we have got two ends, point A and point B. From point A, we have got three wires, 1, 2, and 3. One wire will go to this driver cell, positive, red is positive. The second wire will go to the positive of the Leclanche cell. You can take any cell over here whose internal resistance we are finding out. So this is positive, so we have connected to the positive. This is ammonium chloride solution in a plastic bottle. This is the positive, and this is the carbon rod packed with manganese dioxide. This zinc rod is negative. We have connected the second wire to the positive. There is one more wire, the third wire, that is going to the resistance box. From the negative, we are connecting it to a key. From where the negative ends, that wire will go to the galvanometer. Now the other end of the resistance box will go to the other end of the key. And the other end of the galvanometer will go to the jockey. So that is the jockey. Now let us go to the connection over here. From point A to the positive of the driver cell, negative to the key, key to the rheostat. There are three terminals, 1, 2, 3. One is connected to the key, other is left free, and the arrow terminal is connected to point B. So let us go here. We have connected the negative to the key, key to the lower terminal of the rheostat. This is the rheostat, the lower terminal. There is one more lower terminal here, but we are connecting to this lower terminal. And there is one more terminal here, the top terminal, that will go to point B. So that is the circuit of the internal resistance, for finding internal resistance using potentiometer. So that's the whole circuit. From here, so that's the whole circuit arrangement. Now let us go to the working. So first we will keep K2 open. Now there are two keys. Look at the circuit diagram again. There is one K1 and K2. Okay, so K1 is this one, which you will put it on. And let us put this circuit on over here. So the red is glowing, so we have put circuit on. We have put the EMF voltage, potential difference, over here as 4 volts. Okay, so the driver cell EMF is 4 volts here, 4 to 6 volts. And then this is K2, we have kept it open, we have not put the key here, so it's open. And now we will check the deflection in the galvanometer. So first you will check on point A. So put this at point A. Okay. The galvanometer shows deflection on this side. If you put it on point B, then the deflection is on the other side. Now the adjustment is done. If it does not go to the opposite side, adjust the rheostat. Move it here and there so that you get opposite side deflection. Now let us go to the reading. So with K2 open, go on tapping on this particular wire till the galvanometer shows zero deflection. So whole length of the wire we are tapping this jockey and looking at the galvanometer, so that the galvanometer shows zero deflection. So the galvanometer is showing zero deflection somewhere. Let's see where it is showing zero deflection. Remove the parallax and see zero, and be little fast in taking the reading. So that's your zero. Okay, so we will note down the reading here. You will put the ruler where the jockey was. So the ruler was here. We'll put the jockey here. That shows zero deflection. And now let us check the length. So the length is, now we are coming from here, it is 100 centimeter, turn back 200, and that is 60 centimeter. Okay, so it is 260 centimeter. So we will write it over here, 260 centimeter. Okay, so L1 is 260 centimeter when K2 is open. Now let us put K2 back. We'll put the key K2. Move some resistance over here. I've removed 2 plus 2, 4. Again repeat the same process. Move it from the on the wire such that the galvanometer shows zero deflection. The galvanometer shows zero here. Okay, the galvanometer shows zero here. So let's take the reading now. It is showing zero. We will put a ruler and you will note down the reading. That comes out to be 100.8. So for 4, it is 100.8. Let us put this back. 2 and 2. Put it back. And we'll remove 5 ohms. And check zero deflection again. Again move the jockey on this such that the galvanometer shows zero deflection. So we get zero at 115. So we will just put that there, that particular point where it gives zero. Okay, and that is here. So you go here, see that's 100 here, and then start taking the reading from here because the turning is here. So 115 centimeter. Okay, so that's 115. So for 5, it is 115. Okay, now similarly we will take the readings for 6 and 7. Okay, so we take the readings for 6 and 7 as for 6 it is 120, 7 it is 134.5. And now you will have a formula. This is a formula. Small r is equal to L1 minus L2 upon L2 into S, where this one is your L1. So you will substitute it in this formula and find the answer for the internal. This S is nothing but this RB, the resistance in the box, which is in shunt. S implies shunt. Shunt means parallel. Okay, so that's the formula we have done in theory. Using this, we are going to find out all the internal resistance. So the first one comes out to be 6.317. We have done using calculator. You can do using the second one we have done using logarithms like this. You can use logarithms to find out the second one. It comes out to be 6.305. Oh, the second one is 6.305. Okay, likewise you can find for 6 and 7. So these are the values. Now we will find the mean of all this. the mean comes out to be 6.5382. So the internal resistance of the cell we will write 6.538 or 5382 also you can write that many ohms. So this is how you find the internal resistance of the cell. See, using multimeter we cannot measure the internal resistance of the cell. We have kept it the resistance. We will put the positive and the negative here. See, the multimeter is unable to give you any reading. Why the multimeter is unable to give you any reading? Because it is drawing current from that particular cell. So that is the advantage of this particular potentiometer. You can find out very small resistance of this particular cell also. So that's all for internal resistance of the cell. Bye for now.